Hello friends, it's time to do some useful work and parse the data types presented in the Arduino IDE. Before using variables, objects and functions, we must first declare them in the program text so that the compiler allocates a separate place for them in memory cells, and in order for the compiler to know how much space to allocate in memory. You also need to specify the types of this data when declaring. Also, data types are required by the compiler for the correct interpretation of expressions over them. So let's dive into the wilds of the Arduino rules of the stripped down C language and let the motivation come with us. I promise at the end of the lesson to highlight the most necessary types of created variables. In the meantime, let's start parsing in order with the bool type. The bool data type is used for Boolean variables that store two possible values, true or false. Such variables are useful for creating software flags or latches to store the state of a discrete input for variables that must answer questions like yes or no, on or off, and like this. Here are examples of possible options for declaring such a variable and assigning values to it. We want to remember that all assigned numbers greater than zero will set the bool variable to true. A Boolean variable can be inserted into the digital write function to set the state of the controller's digital output. It is also convenient, as shown in the example, to use a Boolean variable in if statements. In the first example, the condition will work if the variable is in the true state, and vice versa in the second. Byte is an undeservedly underestimated data type for novice programmers, which for some reason has been replaced by the int type, even in most Arduino IDE examples. It's good because it takes up as much space as one memory register of 8-bit Arduino controllers. 8 bits is also occupied by the minimum communication data packet in the UART, I2C and other networks. LCD indicators also accept byte by byte 8-bit data and comments. Therefore, the byte type is indispensable for controller communications with various smart peripherals, for direct work with registers, and well as for storing integer decimal numbers in the range 0 to 255. The char type is designed to work with character data. One variable of this type can store only one text character. The value of a variable can be assigned both through a character in single quotes and a numeric equivalent. The numeric code corresponding to each supported character for this variable type is laid down according to the ASCII table. This type is used for working with strings. Displaying textual information on LCD indicators, text messaging through the port monitor, and so on. Unsigned char is also a character data type, but it can store numeric character codes in the range 0 to 255, considered unless repeatedly received the Golden Boot Award. Now let's look at the ASCII table itself. This is a table of correspondence between symbols embedded in the compiler and their decimal numeric codes. Before the 32nd character, there are unreadable characters. In the example, we use the letter A. We've been trying to find its digital code here. By the way, you won't find a kyrillic here. Its letters begin with the code 192 in the extended ASCII table. We will continue about kyrillic at the end of the lesson. Int and unsigned int are the most popular integer types. They cover a large range of integers, but take up twice as much memory as the byte type. An int variable takes up to 16 bits. Unsigned int, the same type, only without a sign. It covers only positive values. These two types are well suited for storing the read value of an analog input, for example. The long and unsigned long types are used when the size of an int is not enough. They also contain integers, but unlike ints, they take up to 32 bits of memory each. In variables of this type, you can store, for example, the speed of the UART port of the controller, the phone number, the number of milliseconds. Such large numbers in projects are not common, but they do happen. Float is a type of floating point variable or real number. Float allows you to receive and store data values with an accuracy of 6-7 decimal places. Occupies 32 bits in of memory. It's used to store and display the value of physical quantities. The result of mathematical calculations are the arguments of mathematical formulas, mathematical constants, and so on. Pay attention to the examples taken from the Arduino documentation on converting an integer into a real float. There are some nuances here. The double type on other platforms allows you to get the values of numbers with an accuracy up to 30 decimal places. But for Arduino, this type is completely similar to float. The void type is applicable to functions. This is a null type, which means that the function does not return any value. Here, for comparison, then myfunc1 function is shown, returning an int value and three functions that return no value, declared with a void type. When declaring the string type, we use a special class to work with string data. It allows you to work with long texts, limited only by the memory size of a particular controller. The text is assigned to the variable in double quotes. Also, the Arduino IDE provides the string function, which converts the values of various types of variables and constants into string. You see examples of what arguments can be passed to the string function. It is also interesting that the text here can be written even in kyrillic. We will talk more about string variables later. In the meantime, let's remind ourselves of the Arduino data type table. It is not necessary to memorize them all yet, but it will not hurt to familiarize yourself. And in order not to scare beginners too much, keeping the promise, I reduce the most used types of variables to the following simplified table. Basic small projects can be built on just three types of variables presented in this table. Without integer, we will not do almost anywhere. For precise calculations and representations of physical quantities, a floating point type is required. A text string is needed to conveniently display of characters on LCD indicators and the port monitor. For those of you who find this information difficult, review the lesson several times. And thanks for your attentions. I wish you all success and see you soon.